God said, you don't go to the problem. Samson was going through problem that the girl whom he married went away from him. It's a terrible problem. You got married, within a month, the wife has gone away. Still worse, your wife is given to your friend. You are humiliated. You have lost. These are part of life when you don't move with heaven, when you don't obey the voice of God, when you don't remind yourself of who are you to your God, when you don't move with the power of God to destroy the enemy around you, the enemy will be part of you. Until you destroy the enemy around you, the enemy will be found around you. Praise the Lord.
Praise the Lord.
So, when Samson was going through, the Lord told him, don't get into problem and run to God, Lord, Lord, please help me, help me. No, life doesn't move from outside to in. Rather, you get up and be aware of who are you in the Lord. Rejoice in the Lord. God of heaven and earth praise you. Then sings my soul to God my Savior. How great you are. You made the stars. You made the moon. You made the sea. Be aware of the Lord. Your starting point is your God. Your starting point is not problem. Problem become your first point and then go to God as the last resource. No. Let God become your first point and be filled with Him and then move into the problems. Take your God to the problems. Don't take your problems to your God. Don't tell Father. Your Father said, the Bible says, place all your worries upon the Lord, for you have a God who cares for you. And Father is saying, don't take the problem to God. No, I'm not saying that. I'm saying, take the Lord to your problem. Don't merely carry, get stuck up with your problem and you cannot reach. Somebody, I have tied up, take my hands. My wife is pulling, my children are pulling, then I want to go to God. Is it possible? Is it possible? So go to God and take the chocolates or biryani from God. Give to children chocolate, give to your wife biryani. Everybody will be happy.
Praise God.
Praise the Lord. Hallelujah. So our God is teaching through Samson to walk in the spirit means move to God, your first point. Yet let be anything worse situation, your first point is your God. Move with God to move into the world. Carry the Lord. That's why you read the book of James chapter 4 verse 8. So the Lord taught Manoah and later the Lord taught Samson that life is found not from moving from out to in, but it is from moving from in to out. Hallelujah.
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 The fifth thing, the Lord said to Manoah and his wife, and later to Samson, he said, look, take care of your son. Take care of the anointing of the son. Because this son is given a special power to protect the Israelites from the hands of the Philistines. Read that word. So the Lord says the angel, he tells the angel, you know, this child is being given for this purpose. What purpose? That he has to protect the Israelites from the Philistines. So you are sent to the world, maybe amidst the problem. That's why in the book of Acts chapter 14, through many trials, we have to enter into the kingdom of God. So when the trials come, don't get upset. When problems come, don't cry. Maybe God is sending you to problem because you are the answer for the problem.
Amen.
God sends you to the darkness because He has given you the light. Not only to give light to you, but to give light to others. Don't keep your light under the bed. Okay? So, that's what the Lord told her, told Manoah and later to Samson, that you are sent, your power is given, your money is given, your beauty is given, your talents are given, and your education is given, not to show to the world. That's why we read in the book of 1 Corinthians chapter 3 verse 11 onwards. The Christian lives are built by two types of materials. Some people build with the precious stones and gold, which are found in very little amount, and they are not seeable. You can't see the precious stone under the ground. And very few people dig it out and they hold on. Many people are building their lives on that which is seeable, like three things. What are the three things? Hay, wood, and straw. Hay, wood, and straw. You keep this much hay, everybody can see. Appa, this much hay he has got. You want to build up your, these days without wood only, with the painting they show us the wood. That is the world. People think it is wood, it is not wood, it's only painting. So people are build their lives on wood, what they can seeable, you know. This sea nice, beautiful. After some time the paint will go away. Then only we will know what is its color. Many people are want to build on, to show off. I have know this, I know this. Without me nothing will work. They show their money. I am the one who gives the money. I am the one who gives donation. Because of me only the church runs. Many things they speak. And on the day of the Lord, fire will be sent from heaven and it will burn. And that which, if you build your life on that which is not seeable, God, you hunger for God, you thirst for God's presence, such thing, the stone, the precious stone, when it meets the fire, when the gold meets the fire, it will not be crushed, it will be rather purified. Whereas that which is seeable, which we try to heap and show to the world what we are, the hay, the straw, the wood will be burnt into ashes.
For no one can lay any foundation other than the one that has been laid. That foundation is Jesus Christ.
That's true. All of us are baptized because we are on the foundation of Jesus Christ. But being with or built on Christ is not sufficient if you are not built with Christ. What is the meaning of built with Christ? Continue.
Now, if anyone builds on the foundation with gold, silver, precious stones, wood, hay, straw, the work of each builder will become visible, for the day will disclose it, because it will be revealed with fire, and the fire will test what sort of work each has done.
I go to the church, but I want to show what a new pattu sari I have got, how much gold I have got. I want to show to others. Then you should be clear of what is the purpose of your going to the church. It is to meet the Lord. Or, okay. Praise the Lord. Praise. Do you follow what the word of God says? So God teaches Manoah. You are sent into the world. You go to the church. You meet your God for a purpose. Because meeting God is to be aware of the purpose of God for your life. To know the purpose of God and to build up your life according to the purpose of God. That's what God said to Manoah. Hello, my dear. You have to do this, this, this. You can't eat this, this, this. Do you know why? Because the child who has to be born has a mission to accomplish on this earth. So each one of us, if you know whether you are prayed well, when you pray, you will hear, why does God allow this problem or situation to you? So let not that situation make you to cry and make you to be sad. That's what the enemy does. When you pray, you show to God, Lord, I have got plenty of water with me. And that flows through my eyes. No. God says you have got. The moment you come and realize your problem, you understand the power in you, the light in you, the mission of God in you. God is sending you. He has trusted not ABCD, but you. You are the one he has found to take care of your husband, your wife, your children. Hallelujah.
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 Sixth one, as Manoah and husband, his wife prayed, the Lord revealed to them, as long as we are in the mission of God, Lord's protection will be with us. The moment we move away from the mission of God, the enemy will come to capture us. So as long as you move with the mission of God, as long as Samson was doing God's will, God was with him.